Okay, good morning once again, students. So welcome back to our online class today. And this is our last review for this week. And next week will be your midterm exam. So don't forget to study the coverage for our midterm exam, chapter 4. Study, read your books, division, about division, also chapter 5, mixed operations, chapter 9, about length, okay, and the last one is chapter 10, which is about weight. So these are the coverage for your midterm exam. Now, today, we're going to answer some questions here, and let's try to solve each other for our review. Okay, so just look at the screen and follow our discussion this morning so that you will learn and you can remember these lessons for your preparation in the coming midterm exam. Okay, so are you ready for the review? You can use scratch paper there for solving some parts here. So first, look at here. Find the quotient and remainder when 97 is divided by 4, or 97 divided by 4. What is the correct answer here? Okay. So let's try to solve 97. You can solve also there. Divided by, Winton answers B. Are you sure? Divided by 4. Okay, 97. Oh, sorry. 97 divided by 4. Ah. 2 times 4, 8. Minus, bring down one, bring down 7, 9 minus 8, 1, bring down 7, 4, yeah, you're correct. So 16 minus, the answer is 24, remainder 1. Okay, next, how about this? Who answers A? B, C, D. Okay. Winton's answers B, 30. Is that correct? 210 divided by 7 equals 30. You just divide 21 divided by 7. 3. Then there's a 0. The answer is 30. Yeah. It's correct. 30. 210 divided by 7 equals 30. Okay. Next here, how about this? 234 divided by 6. What is the answer? Let's solve. Let's try to solve. 234 divided by 6. So 0, 23 is 3, correct? 3 times 6, 18. Okay, follow there. Minus becomes 1, becomes 13. 5, 30 minus 8 is 5, bring down 4, 54. 54 divided by 6. 54 divided by 6. Huh? 54 divided by 6.
9.
Oh, very good. So
9.
9 times 6, 54. Okay, so the answer now here is 39. 39. Very good. So you need to solve carefully. Do not just guess. You need to solve it. How about this? Okay, this one. Word problem. 364 pupils are put into 7 equal groups. How many pupils are there in each group? So 364 divided by 7. What's the answer? What's your answer to this problem? What do you think?
52.
Are you sure? Okay, let's solve. 5. Okay, 36 divided by 7 is 5. Times 7, 35. Minus 1. Bring down 4, 14. Correct. So the answer is 52. Okay, very good. Next, how about this? Tom has 56 books. He places them equally on 7 tables. How many books are there on each table? How many? Divided by 7. What's the answer? Oh, very good. So correct answer is 8. So there are 8 books. 8 books in on each table. Okay. Next, look at here. Combined operation, mixed operation. What is 800 times 10 divided by 5?
1,600.
So take note that you need to solve first the numbers that are in the bracket. So 800 times 10. This is 8,000. Pananat answers A. Is that correct? Now let's solve. Let's solve so that we will know. 8,000 divided by 5. Now let's solve. 8 divided by 5. 1. 1 times 5. 5. 8 minus 5.
3.
Bring down?
0.
30 divided by 5.
6.
You have already here. Very good. 30. And then 0. Then you have 2 zeros here, right? So put the zeros here. Very good. So your answer is correct. 1,600. Okay. That's how we solve combined or mixed operations. Okay, let's review about length. What is the length of the pencil?
60 centimeters.
Obviously, okay, centimeters. So you can see here, 16 cm or centimeters. This one, if you answer this one, this is wrong. Okay, so take note, you need to read carefully and look at the units. So in centimeters, 16 centimeters. All right, how about this? There's a word problem here. A sausage is 180 millimeters long. You know what is sausage? Like this, you like to eat sausage? Yeah, sausage. 180 millimeters long. But then cuts 55 cuts. Cut because maybe he eat the half at the other. Okay. Cuts how many millimeters? 55. So, what is the remaining? This is minus. So, 180 minus 55. What is the answer? What is the answer? Huh? What is your answer?
Five.
135. Ah, they're here. So the remaining is 125 millimeters. Okay. Let's go. Let's go to the next. Look at here. It's still about length. Which of the following is the standard unit? Standard unit for measuring lengths. Which one?
A.
Ah, this is the standard. Okay, why we call this standard unit? Because you can see here the standard, the numbers. Okay, you can measure the object exactly based on the numbers. But this one, these are not standard. These are called non-standard unit. Okay, next here. Which of the following is used to measure body, dress, and pants? Which one?
B.
This one? Wrong. Roller? You cannot fold the roller?
B.
This one is hard to fold. And the answer is, this one is the correct, okay? This one, the measuring, body measuring tape is the correct tool to measure body, dress, and pants. Next. Now, let's go to non-standard. Which of the following is a non-standard unit? Which one? Non-standard unit for measuring length. What is your answer?
C.
Yeah.
C.
This one, okay. This is called non-standard hand span. All right. Next. Yeah, that's correct. Next, what is the length of a pencil? 8 millimeters. What's your answer?
19 millimeters.
Take note, millimeters, okay?
19 times 10.
Because 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. So correct answer is 90 millimeters. Okay. Next. Word problem. Ben is 138 centimeters tall. Tommy is 10 centimeters taller than Ben. Question, what is the height of Ben in centimeters? Tommy is taller than 10 centimeters. So, meaning 138 minus 10. It should be. It should be Tommy here. It should be Tommy. I forgot to change. This one is Tommy, not Ben. Sorry. This is Tommy, okay? What is the height of Tommy? I forgot to change. In centimeters. So, Ben is 138. So, 138 plus Tommy is taller than Ben. 10 centimeters, so plus 10. What is the answer?
148.
Yeah, because 148. Sorry, I forgot to change here. This is Tommy. I mean, there is Ben. Goodbye, Ben. It's Tommy. So the answer is 148
centimeter.
Okay. Yeah, that's it. Next, let's go to the next one. Let's go to mass or weight. What is the mass of a watermelon?
3 kilograms.
Okay, so 3 kilograms. Then how many lines here? 1, 2. So each line is 1 kid. So 2 kids.
3 kilograms and 2 kids.
Yeah, correct. Yes. That's correct. 3 kilograms and 2.
And 2 kids.
Very good. Next, what is the mass of the pumpkin?
4 kilograms.
Ah, very easy, right? The pointer is pointing at 4. So don't be in a harsh.
Four kids.
You answering this? Maybe you answer 4 kids. It's wrong.
It's 4 kilograms. No, four kids.
It's 4.
No.
Kilograms.
4 kilograms is correct.
Kg. Yeah, kg, kilograms. All right. Next, how much does the fruits weigh?
750.
Yeah, here is 50. Half of 100 is 50. So 750.
750
grams. You can see here, letter G.
Yeah,
grams.
I see it. It's
yes. Very. It's in grams. All right. Let's go to the next. This is problem. There are 25 kilograms and 5 kids of mangoes in a box. 20 kids of mangoes are added. Oh, remember, added. What is the total weight? Total. So this is plus of the mangoes in the box now. What's your answer?
D. D.
D, B. So take note, 20 kids is equal to how many grams? How many kilograms?
2 kilograms.
Because 1 kilogram, 10 kids. So 25 plus 2. 25 plus 2. Yes, plus 2.
Kilograms.
So the answer is 27 kilograms and 5 kids. Can you see
27 kilograms and 5 kids.
So the total weight of the mangoes in the box now is 27 kilograms and 5 kids. All right, next. Oh, another road problem. The weight of the motorbike is 150 kilograms and the weight of the bike is 18. What is the difference? So when you see difference, this is minus
132 kilograms.
So, 10.
10.
4.
5 is 4. And 8. 10 plus.
10 minus. 10 minus 8. 2. 4 2. Minus 1. 3.
3.
Ah.
And
1. 132 kilograms. So the difference in their weight is 132 kilograms. Right? Next. Okay, look at this. Which one is the which is the most appropriate unit? Appropriate units of measurement used to measure sack of rice. Huh? Is it grams, kilograms, kids, or metric tons?
Kilograms.
Yes, kilograms. It's in kilograms. Okay.
Yes.
The appropriate. Okay. The appropriate is kilogram.
Kilograms.
Okay, good. Next.
The hardest way to make.
Let's go here. Which animal is the heaviest?
Elephant.
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 Okay, this one very big. Okay.
Yes,
next. Really big. Which one is the lightest?
Shark.
Yeah. The lightest is the shark.
Because it's really small. Because it's
yes.
Really small.
You can see the measurement, huh? Their weight difference. Okay. Let's proceed to word problem here again. Maria and Cindy bought 28 kilograms and 600 grams and 22,850 grams of rice. They donated all the rice to an orphanage. What is the total mass of rice donated by them? So total, it's a plus. What's the answer? That is the answer. Let's solve. 28. Nino, what's your answer? Nino is raising her hand or his hand. What's your answer? Huh? What is now the total? 32, you add. Because if you convert 28 kilograms and 600
and 650
68,450
grams. Okay, very good. 56 plus 8, 14, carry 1. 11, carry 1. 61,450 grams. Okay.
Because it's very mini.
Yeah, that's the total mass. Total mass. Okay, let's review. Let's go to conversion. Okay, let's review about conversion. First, let's review conversion of length, units of length, okay? Take note, remember that 1 centimeter is equal to 10
millimeters. 1 centimeter is meter, 1 meter. And
this one
1,000 meter is 1 kilogram.
Okay. So 1 meter, 100 centimeters, 1 kilometer, 1,000 meters. Now let's convert.
20
How many millimeters?
Millimeter.
Huh?
20 millimeter. 20.
What's your answer?
70
meter. Okay, times 10. 70 millimeters. Just add 10. You can see here 10. So 70. Very easy, right? Next. How about 25 centimeters to millimeters?
250 millimeters.
Yeah, you add 10. So 250.
Millimeters.
Yeah, that's it. Because 25 times 10. Okay, next. How about 5 meters and 80 centimeters? How many centimeters?
518 centimeters.
Yeah, very good. So 5 meters. This is 500.
5 meter is 500 centimeters.
500.
Plus 80. Plus 500.
580 centimeters.
580 centimeters.
All right. Next, 15 meters. How many centimeters?
1,500 centimeters.
Oh, very good. That's correct. 1,500 centimeters. Two zeros here. Two zeros. Add two zeros. Okay. Next. 8 kilometers. How many meters?
8,000.
So take note here. 1 kilometer.
8,000 meters.
Equals 1,000 meters.
One kilogram equals 1,000 meters.
I forgot to add S here. Yes. 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 Okay. Let's go to grams. Kilograms, kids. Okay. Conversion. Let's review this. Take note that 1 kilogram, how many grams? 1,000 grams. 1 kilogram, how many kids? 10 kids. Yes. 1 kid, how many grams? 100 grams. Now, let's try to convert here. 4 kilograms, how many grams?
4,000 grams.
Yeah, plus 3 zeros. So 4,000 grams. Okay, that's it. Next, how about this? 80 kilograms. How many kids?
800 kids.
Okay, kids. So add 1 zero. So 80 plus 1 zero. So 800 kids or times 10. What? 10 minutes more. Okay. Let's move. How about 6,000 grams? How many kids? 6,000 grams. How many kids?
50 kids.
Minus 2 zeros. Because going to kids. Minus.
16 kids.
Okay, very good. That's the answer. 60 kids. So get the 2 zeros and the answer is 60. Divide 100. Okay. Let's go to this. Kids to kilograms. How many kilograms? 350 kids.
35
kilograms. Minus 1 zero. 35. Kilograms. All right. So now, how about 48,000? How many kilograms? 48 kilograms.
48 kilograms.
Okay, 48 kilograms. Because 3 zeros here. 1 kilogram, 1,000. So erase the 3 zeros. That's the answer. Okay. Now let's go to division. Let's review division. 624 divided by 4. Let's solve. Follow. So 6 divided by 4. 1. 1 times 4. 4.
1 times 4 is 4.
Minus.
Minus
2. 2. Bring down.
2.
2.
22 divided by 4.
22 divided by 4.
5.
5.
Five times 4.
30.
Minus 2.
Minus 2.
4.
24 divided by 4.
6.
6 times 4. 24. zero.
Zero. And
the answer is
156.
Okay. Next, how about this? Four digit number. So let's include the two because it's small number. 12 divided by 7.
It's one
times 7.
Seven.
Minus.
Yeah.
Five.
Minus. Six.
Oh, sorry. Five. 12 minus 7 is 5, right?
5.
Bring
down. Bring
down
3.
53 divided by 7.
7.
7 times 7.
7 times 7 is
49, correct?
49.
Yes. 53 minus 49. 13 minus 9.
4.
Bring down. 49 divided by 9.
7
times 7. 49. 0. So the answer is 177. Okay, next. How about this? 28 divided by 5.
4.
5, correct?
4.
5. 25.
Minus.
3. Bring down.
Bring down 6.
36 divided by 5.
26 divided by 5.
7, correct? 7. 7 times 5. 35.
1.
Minus.
1.
So, the answer is 57. Remainder.
1.
Okay, so I think you know this already, how to solve using long division method. This is long division method. Next, how about this? 68 divided by 8. 8, correct? 8 times 8. 60. 4. Am I correct?
Yes.
8 minus 4. 4. Bring down.
9.
49 divided by 8.
6.
Okay, thank you. Very good. 6 times 8. 48. So minus 1. Bring down.
3.
13 divided by 8.
1.
1 times 8. 8. 13
eight.
Minus 8.
5.
5. So, 861 remainder.
5.
So, this is the answer. All right. This one, last mixed operations. Let's try to solve this. 76 times 6. 76 times 6. 6 times 6.
36
carry 3. 7 times 6. 42, correct? Plus 3.
8. 46.
45, correct? Am I correct?
Yeah.
42 plus 3, 45. So, 456 divided by 4. 4 divided by 4. 1 times 4. 4. 0. Bring down 5. 5 divided by 4.
1.
4. Minus 1, bring down 6. 16 divided by 4.
4.
4 times 4, 16. 0. So the answer is 140. 15. Okay. So this is how to solve mixed operation. Huh? Take note that you need to solve first numbers that are in the bracket. Okay, then after that solve from left to right. Continue solving it. Okay. So, oh, 2 minutes more. So do you have any questions?
No.
Do you understand?
Yes.
Okay. Are you ready for the midterm exam?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes.
So you need to be ready and you need to study more because this is the coverage for chapters. So you need to study this and remember what you have learned in our class. And yeah, you need to study so that you can answer the questions. You can get high score. Okay, so that's all for this morning. If you don't have questions, and good luck to your exam next week. Google Form, still online in Google Form. So be ready and thank you for joining. Goodbye, class. That's all for today. 1 minute more. Thank you and bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Study. You study, huh? You study. Read your books. Read your books. Okay, let's see in the exam. Okay, bye-bye. Keep safe always. Keep safe. God bless.
Bye-bye.
Bless you.